We have a right angled triangle here. We're given the measurement of the hypotenuse, that's the side opposite the 90 degree angle, and one of the short sides, and we have to find the other short side. We're asked to calculate the length of side X, obviously this one, right? And we have the different options for the answer. Now, straight ahead, we recognize that we'd have to use the Pythagoras theorem. And basically, the Pythagorean states that the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other sides, where C is the hypotenuse. So opposite its right angle, we have C, which is the length of this side. This is the hypotenuse. So we're going to replace C with 9 root 10, and that's the value of C, so we have to square that. And A and B are the lengths of these two sides. So we can consider this to be A and this to be our B. So replacing A with X, we square it. Replacing B with the value 27 to the power of 2/3, we also have to square that quantity. And then we try to find the X value. Okay, so to do this, I will simplify the terms that we have here. Now, we should recall that if we have two quantities, let's say we have AB to the second power, it's going to be A squared B squared. Let's say we have A to the M, B to the N, and raise it to another power, let's say X, then it's going to be A to the power of M times X times B to the power of N times X. So the power is distributive over multiplication, all right? And multiply power by power. So this is called the power rule. Okay, so we have a quantity here. Think of the 9 as A and think of the root 10 as B. We're going to square the 9. We're going to get 81. And we're going to square root 10. Now, when we square a square root, it cancels out. And so we're going to leave back with just 10. So remember, these two quantities are multiplying. 9 multiplied by root 10. And so it's 81, that's 9 squared 81, times square of square root of 10, that's going to be 10. Square cancels out the square root. And then we're going to have X squared. Can't simplify that any further for sure. And we can rewrite this differently. Now, what is this really saying here? Well, this is saying, let's look at it over here. If we have a quantity, A to the power of M over N, this we're going to keep as the power, and this we're going to treat as the root. So what we're saying here is the nth root of A to the power of M. So let's go back to this down here. So what we're saying here is the third root. Notice that the 3 is in the denominator, so that's the root. So it's the third or the cube root of 27. And the 2 here means to the power of 2. Now, bear in mind, we have another 2 outside here, so we're going to have to now square that answer after. Okay, so 81 times 10, that's 810. And X to the power of 2, leave that as it is. Plus, by the plus sign, that's here. And then now, the cube root of 27 is 3. Because we know that 3 times 3 times 3 is equal to 27, which means the cube root of 27 is 3. What quantity do we need to multiply by itself 3 times to get 27? And that's 3. So this is 3, and if what this power of 2 here, and then the other one outside. Now 3 squared is actually what is 3 squared? 3 squared is actually 9, so we can actually just put that value in. And 9 squared is actually 81, so we'll have 810. Let's transpose this positive 81, 9 squared is 81, transpose it to the left. Now, so once we are transposing a term, the operation changes. So we have addition, it goes over as a subtraction. So subtract 81 equals x squared. In fact, what we're really doing is subtracting 81 from both sides. So we subtract 9 squared from this side, and we subtract 9 squared from this side as well. Okay, so this cancels out, in other words. And we are left with x squared on this side. And so we say 810 minus 81. Okay, good. So we have x squared is equal to, now we want to find the difference between 810 and 81. Using our calculator, 810 minus 81, and that gives us 729. Now we square root both sides, square root in this side, that gives us x, and square root in this side, and that will give us 27. Okay, now which one of these values is equivalent to or equal to 27? Well, it would have to be this one, because 3 times 3 times 3, just as we have here, which is really 3 to the power of 3, is equal to 27. So our answer is B.